My name is Dr. Teresa Larson. I'm a doctor of physical therapy, a former Marine Corps officer, a wife, a mother, and today I'm presenting to you on sleep. Sleep is one of the most essential actions we must take daily to allow our bodies and minds to recover from the day's stimulus and stress, and to both process and store memories banked during the day. Sleep quite literally helps all the systems of our body to rest and recharge, all of them. Sleep quality is a primary lever of our health. When we give our body adequate sleep, we improve not only our mood, but also how our body feels, our pain levels, and our ability to maintain focus. On the other hand, when we ignore this basic need, chronic, inadequate sleep can lead to an increased risk for musculoskeletal injuries, orthopedic things like joint soft tissue, connective tissue issues, mood disorders, anxiety, depression, heart disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, and even stroke. The good news is that most of us can control our sleep with a few tweaks in our routine. How sleep keeps us functioning at an optimal level are these ways. On a biological level, sleep is a complex physiological process that serves many functions. Rather than being a passive rest, sleep is a metabolically active process when our bodies release many chemical signals and hormones to repair our tissues and boost our immunity. When we don't sleep well, muscle protein synthesis is reduced and inflammation increases, which limits our ability to repair muscle damage and positively respond to exercise. Further, when we are sleeping, hormones like growth hormone and testosterone rise, helping maintain our body's muscle tone while keeping us full of vitality. How does sleep impact our mood? Well, our emotional wellness is also impacted and recharged by sleep. Unsurprisingly, sleep deprivation and restriction has been shown to drop our sociability, confidence, ability to cope with stressors, optimism, and positive mood states. It does this while simultaneously increasing our negative mood states such as depression, anxiety, frustration, and even irritability. So sleep modulates daytime pain levels as well. How does it do this? Well, sleep plays a role in processing pain and is especially important in cases of persistent, long-lasting pain, what we consider chronic pain. When we don't sleep well or long enough, this sleep deprivation heightens activity in our brain's pain processing circuitry. The result is lower thresholds for pain and increased generalized body discomfort, like body aches, back aches, stomach aches, muscle pain, joint pain, headaches, things like that. It is important to note that this relationship works in both directions. Poor sleep quality results in increased pain, while high pain interferes with quality sleep. This means it is critical to address both sleep and pain in our pursuit of emotional and physical wellness. We can take advantage of this two-way relationship by using sleep hygiene tactics before bed to help dampen pain, and in the waking hours by using therapeutic exercise and movement to decrease pain and thereby help sleep. So here's some examples of daytime recharge. In addition to traditional sleep times, daytime rest and opportunities to recharge are also important for health. We know that people who do not take breaks from sitting during the day are at a much higher risk of health concerns like diabetes, weight gain, and general mortality. A daytime recharge might look like any of the following: a 5-minute meditation, a 5-minute focus on the breath, thinking of breathing low, like into the diaphragm, belly, and back versus just the chest, a 10-minute walk outside in nature, or just a 10-minute walk, a 5-minute yoga flow of your favorite yoga exercises, or simply getting on the floor, which is great for you, and stretching. Other examples, like taking some leisure time, starting a hobby. Vacations are important to also improve our mood, energy, and well-being. Other ways are spending time with family, meeting with a group of friends to go for a walk or hike or make a dinner together, or discuss a book together, or any other activities that are meaningful for you. And it doesn't have to take much time. So I have some questions for you. Why do you think you don't rest well? What could be better in your mind? If you feel you rest well, what is working well for you? So here's some stats. The American Federal Sleep Association recommends 7.5 to 8 hours of sleep at night for adults. If you do not feel rested in the mornings, that means your sleep could be improved. Our goal here with all of this is to match your perception with what is actually happening in your life and to share with you information that you can apply to your life right now. Sleep is a crucial part of our life. We spend roughly 33% of our time sleeping. So making sure it is quality will help improve all aspects of our life and all systems of our body. So I'm just gonna review real briefly what it impacts again. Cognitive and emotional benefits to sleep. There's many. It improves your mood. It improves the brain-derived neurotrophic factor, BDNF, which is equivalent to this miracle grow for the brain and body. It's improved by sleep. It improves your memory. It improves your physical, hormonal, and pain benefits. It improves tissue recovery. You experience less pain when you get better sleep, and you will have improved longevity.